Good morning all. Today we are going to discuss two alternators when connected in parallel on load conditions, how they behave. So let us assume initially there are two generators which are connected like this to the load. So let us assume that initially both the alternators are supplying the equal load, that is I1 is equal to I2 and the power factor 1 is equal to power factor 2 and the active and reactive power are equally shared among them. So in that conditions, so when the changes happens, so how they are going to change. So before going to that, let us see what will be the equivalent diagram of this. So I am representing KVAR on the y-axis and kilowatt on the x-axis. This is KVAR. So let us assume both the cases the voltage, terminal voltage is same. So I am taking this as voltage V. Same thing is the voltage V for the second generator. So the I component in phase with the voltage, that leads to active power. I component which is out of phase with the voltage, that leads to reactive power. We are going to use that concept here. So let us assume the value of I1, this is my value of I1. So this value of I2 is also equal to I1. So it is in the opposite direction, because when you are taking in this loop, within this loop, we can take there in opposite direction. So I am taking this as I2. So let us assume this I2 is making an angle of phi2. So I1 is angle making an angle of phi1. So in this case, power factor 1 is equal to power factor 2. That means the phi2 will be equal to phi1. So both are same. So I1 is equal to I2. So now to get the value of the E, so I have to add this I into R with that I into X. So when you add this, you will get your value of the voltage E1. So similar way, for this voltage, I have to add the I into R, then I into X. So you will observe that it will come exactly 180 degrees opposite to this. This is my value of E2. Or if you take the net result, E1 and E2 within this loop are in opposite direction. So they cancel each other. There is no synchronizing component of current. So getting it? So now this I component in phase with the voltage. So this gives the component of I cos phi. So this V into I cos phi, that gives active power. Similar way, whatever is this current, so this component gives I2 cos phi2 component, this is I1 cos phi1 component. Getting it? This way I can do, or this can be represented in some another way also. Let us see that also, because whichever is easy for you, you can follow that one. So what I am doing, I am dividing the KVAR and kilowatt in the form of a triangle. Let us assume this is my load KVAR, or total KVAR that should be supplied, and this will be load kilowatt. This is my total power that should be supplied. So this will be equally shared by this. That means kilowatt hour is also half, KVAR is also half initially. So from this we extended line, and from this we extended line. So actually these two will intersect in the triangle. So here I have drawn it wrong. So I am just changing it. So these two are equally sharing it. So let us assume this is shared by this. So KVAR also shared half, and KVA also kilowatt also shared half. This is my angle phi1, this is my angle phi2. So let us assume this is machine 1 and this is machine 2. So let us see how the things will change when the load is changing, when we come across this. So let us see now the effect of excitation. So before going to the effect of the excitation, the effect of change in the load, I want that you should know what is the synchronizing power and how it comes when there is a disturbance due to excitation, when there is a disturbance due to load. This thing I have already discussed in my previous lecture, that is parallel operation of alternators under no load condition. I suggested everyone to please check that first before seeing this video, so that you will clearly understand what I am teaching here. So I am leaving the link in the I tab above. If you have not seen my previous video, please see it and then come to this. So whenever there is a change in excitation, we have seen there, when the machine 1 excitation is changed, excitation is increased for machine number 1. So when excitation is increased, the EMF generated by the machine 1 will increase. So the E1 is increased. Let us assume the increased value of E1 is E1 dash. Let us see what is the consequence of this change in all these things. So again, I am redrawing the things. So this is my kilowatt and this is my KVAR. So I am directly taking my value of E1. This is now changed to E1 dash. So this is my value of E2, because E1 is equal to E2 initially. So E1 dash, the EMF is increased. So the difference of E1 dash minus E2, this I can call as ESY. That gives my synchronizing component of the voltage. So ESY will be in phase with E1. So let us take it as ESY. So because of this ESY, the current will start circulating. because this current that is circulating in this loop will be circulating like this. So in this loop you can tell that this is one load and this is second load. This load is, because when resistance is neglected, it is pure inductive. So the current that passes will be lagging behind this voltage by 90 degrees. So this is what we discussed in detail in the last class. So because of this, some small component of ISY will pass. This ISY will be lagging behind this by 90 degrees. Getting it up to here, it is clear. So let us take the different components now. So previously, initially the value of I1, let us take this, this is my value of I1 and this is my value of I2. These are initially I1 is equal to I2 or phi1 is equal to phi2. So now the net resultant current that is supplied by the first one will be the sum of I1 plus ISY. So I am just adding them. So when you add them, this will be your resultant value. This is my I1 dash. Similarly, I have to add my value of I1 plus ISY. So if you add I1 plus ISY, so it will come like this. So this is my value of I2 dash. This is my value of I2 dash. So in that way, the currents will change. So now I2 dash, you can see this power factor angle. Main thing is I want to tell this. So this power factor angle phi2 is decreased. So in this case, this because of I1 dash, the angle I1 is increased. So we can tell that the power factor 1 is decreased and the power factor 2 is increased. This is what is happening. So let us try to elaborate the current so that you will understand the remaining things. So how the components are varying. So I am just zooming it and redrawing here. So let us assume this is my value of I1, because generally the value of I1 is very high and the value of ISY is very small compared to that. So this is my value of ISY. So I1 plus ISY, this gives my value of I1 dash. So this I1 dash, if you take, this is my value of KVAR that is supplied by the initial conditions. Now because of this increase in I1 dash, this becomes KVAR1 dash. This is changed. So similarly, the kilowatt 1 initially and now, this is KW1, this is my KW1 dash. So kilowatt is increased. So you will observe that when compared to the change in the KW, the change in KVAR will be more, because the effect of change in the KVAR will be more in this case. Getting it? Similar way, if you go to the second side, let us assume initially this is my value of I2. So this I2, I have to add the value of ISY. So you, when you add the value of ISY, this is my value of ISY. So this gives my resultant value. This is my I2 dash. So because of I2 dash, so initially this is my KVAR2 and KVAR2 dash. The KVAR is changed. Now coming to the kilowatt side, so this will be the change in kilowatt. This is KW2, KW2 dash. So here also same thing, the KVAR2 dash is less than KVAR2. That means KVA, reactive power that is supplied by the machines 2 is decreased and reactive power supplied by the machine 1 is increased. KVAR1 dash is greater than KVAR1. So whenever the excitation is changed, because there will be change in the active power supply also, but that effect is less when compared to the change in the reactive power. This is what happens practically. Getting it? So I am just summarizing these things, then we will see in some other way how to analyze this one. So I1 dash will be equal to I1 plus ISY, synchronizing component of current. Similarly, I2 dash is will be equal to I2 plus ISY. So this will increase and this will decrease. This is what happens. So I2 dash, that means the current that is supplied by the second one is decreased. So then I can tell that kilowatt 1 dash will be approximately equal to KW1. Change is there, but change will be generally negligible, very less. So similarly, this will be equal to KW2, but there will be a change in KVR. KVR1 dash is equal to KVR1. Similarly, KVAR2 dash is less than KVAR2. Okay. So we can tell that as excitation is increased, so KVAR is increased by the respective machine. When KVR is increased, the cost phi will decrease. When KVR is increased, cos phi will decrease. So how to analyze this cos phi? The cos phi can analyze in another way also, because cos phi is equal to power P divided by the KVA rating of the machine. This is nothing but power P divided by power P square plus Q square, because KVA is square root of P square plus Q square. So power P is nearly constant, but whichever machine is supplying more load or excitation is increased, this Q is increased. So as a result of this, this value will decrease. So same thing is resembling here. You can remember in this way, otherwise you will confuse. So only you should know that whenever the excitation is increased, only KVR is changed. So accordingly you can calculate all the remaining formulas. So I am just summarizing this. This is machine number 1, this is machine number 2. So it is observed that this excitation of machine number 1, this excitation is increased for this machine number 1. Then what is happening? KW1 will be equal to KW2. This is not changed. Then KVAR1 is increased and KVAR2 is decreased. I1 is increased and I2 is decreased. And power factor is decreased in this case, power factor is increased in this case. So this is one way of analysis. Let us see another way and simple way of analysis, how to calculate it practically. So in that case, so again I am drawing in the similar diagram. So you are taking the triangle. So let us assume this is my initial value of my triangle. So this is my value of KVAR that is supplied, and this is my value of kilowatt, total kilowatt that is supplied by different conditions. So initially let us assume both are sharing equally. Let us assume initial condition is this one. So this is KW2 and this is KW1. So similarly this will be KVAR1, this is KVAR2, kilowatt hour, that is KVAR that is supplied by the second machine. Getting it? So initially this angle is equal to phi 2, this angle is equal to phi 1. This is my initial condition. Now what happens, because of the change in excitation, the reactive power, overall reactive power will increase. So the reactive power is going to shift, whereas the active power will not change. That means what we have to do, we have to just extend this KVA1. So wherever this intermediate section is, just extend it. Now you will draw the respective value of KVA after calculating the effect of KVR, because KVR supplied by machine 1 will increase, KVR supplied by the machine 2 will decrease. Getting it? So overall the rating, overall the, because the load is not changed, only excitation of the machine is changed. So that's why this triangle will shift like this. The KVR supplied is changed, whereas the kilowatt change is same. That means this will be your new value of your triangle. Getting it? So this is my KVAR2 dash and this will be my KVAR. One dash, KVA that is supplied by the respective things are changed, whereas the kilowatt 1 dash will be equal to KW1, KW2 dash will be equal to KW2. As this triangle is shifted, now you can see here this is my angle of phi 1 dash and this will be my value of phi 2. Okay, in this way also you can analyze. So I am just explaining this once again because there may be little bit of confusion. First thing is you have to take your load. So this is my total load, KVAR of the load. So this is my total load kilowatt, because total load is not changed. So initially let us assume they are sharing in this manner. So this is the kilowatt and KVR supplied by the respective. So this is kilowatt supplied by the second machine, this is kilowatt supplied by the first machine, this is KVR supplied by the first machine, this is KVAR supplied by second machine. Getting it? So now, because of the change in the excitation, because overall KVA requirement is not changed, but KVA supplied by the each machine is changed. So and kilowatt hour supplied by each machine is same. So that's why extend this line like this. So now project to whatever KVAR that new machine is supplying, because you can calculate from the formulas. So now your triangle will shift like this. So it will come to this point and from this point it will go. Total KVR supplied is not changed. So because of this change, so initially this is my value of phi 1, the phi 1 is now changed to phi 1 dash. So initially the value of phi 2 is there. So this is the new KVR that is supplied by the respective. So initially this is my value of phi 2. So this will become equal to phi 2 dash. So we can tell that phi 2 dash is decreased and the value of phi 1 dash is increased. So this is what happens. So in this way also you can calculate it. Getting it? So let us now see what will be the effect of steam input. Effect of steam input. So now again, I hope that you have already seen the basic thing, what is the value of ISY and other things. So on those basics I am proceeding further, because it will be easier for me. So whenever the steam excitation is increased, same way you can draw the diagram, when steam input is increased, when the steam input is increased, what will happen? The first machine will try to dominate the second one, or we can tell the frequency of the first machine is increased. When the frequency of first machine is increased, how the things are going to affect, that thing I am drawing here. Again same thing, I am taking kilowatt in the x-axis, this KVAR in the y-axis, kilowatt in the first axis. Let us assume my initial condition, this is my voltage V and this is my initial value of current I1. Similarly, this is my voltage V and this is my initial value of
I2. Getting it? So V plus IR plus I into X, this gives my value of E1. Similarly, V plus IR plus J times of IX, this gives my value of E2. So E1, E2 are clear. So accordingly, the angles will come. So this is my angle phi1 and this is my angle phi2. This is my initial condition. Now, because of change in the effect of the input, automatically the frequency of machine 1 increases. Due to the effect of change in the input, so E will shift little bit forward. The magnitude of E will depend on the excitation. So magnitude of E is not changed. It is like a circle. So this E is shifted. So this becomes E1 dash, whereas the angle is there. Angle shift is changed. So whenever the angle shift is there, there is 180, E2 and E1 are not 180 degrees opposite to each other. They are displaced by some angle. As a resultant of this, so if you are calculating the resultant of this, you will get this value of ISY, which will be something like this is my value of ESY. So because this will come by resultant of these two things, you can just try to calculate it. Now the current that is passing, the synchronizing component of current, will be 90 degrees lagging behind this ESY. If you calculate that, you will get your value of ISY will be like this. This is my value of ISY. So when there is a change in the ISY, now let us see what will be the effect of these things. So I am elongating these things and trying to draw the things so that it will be more clear to you. So what will be the effect now? So this is my initial value of I1 and this is my initial value of I2. So now this ISY, so ISY, you can see this is my value of ISY. So this will be nearly coming like this. This is my value of ISY. So for this I1, this is kilowatt and this is kVAr. Please mark it, because otherwise we'll confuse. So for this, I have to add this value of ISY. This is my value of ISY. So this gives my resultant value of the current I1. I1 dash. Similarly, for this, if you add this value of ISY, so this is my value of ISY. So this is my value of I2 dash. This is my value of I2 dash. So let us try to see the angles. So initially, this is my angle phi1. So now the angle phi1 is changed to phi1 dash. So similarly, initially, this is my angle phi2. This phi2 is changed to phi2 dash. So you can see in both these cases, this kVAr2 is equal to kVAr2 dash nearly. Similar way, you can see here this I1 dash and I1 nearly will be in phase. So kVAr1 will be approximately equal to kVAr1 dash. But if you see the kilowatt, this is kilowatt 1 initially supplied. So this is kilowatt 1 dash, it is increased. Similarly, the kilowatt here, this is kilowatt supplied in initial conditions. This is kilowatt supplied after changing. So from this we can observe that whenever the steam input of any machine is increased, so let us take it as machine 1 and machine 2, what are the changes? So for this, steam input is increased for the machine 1. So the first change is the kVAr1 is equal to kVAr2. This is what we observe. Then kilowatt 1 is increased and kW2 is decreased. The active power supplied is decreased. And the second one, the I1 is increased and the second one I2 is decreased. And the power factor 1 is increased and power factor 2 is decreased. Again, the power factor, how to calculate? We know power factor is equal to P divided by P square plus Q square. So if you take the first machine reactive power is not changed, but the active power is increased. Getting it? So reactive power is not changed, but the active power is increased. So as a result of this, the power factor will improve in this case. Getting it? So whereas in the second machine, it will be opposite. There will be no change in the reactive power. There is a change in the active power only, because active power is decreased there. I think it is clear to you. So let us proceed and try to analyze in some different way. So before proceeding to that, first thing you have to observe this, whenever the steam input is increased, the set speed, as effect of this, the set speed will increase, then your machine will start operating at a higher frequency. So before going to that, let us try to analyze the same thing in the different way, that is triangular form, so that whichever is convenient to you, you can follow that. So in the triangle again, because my load is constant, this is my kVAr of my load, this is kilowatt, total kilowatt of my load. Initially, let us assume it is shared in this way. So this is kW1, this is kW2, kVAr1, and this is kVAr2, and this is my angle of phi1, this is my angle phi2. So in this case, kVAr is not changed, only kilowatt is going to change. That means you have to extend the kVAr triangle like this. So now you draw according to the kilowatt shared by the respective things. Getting it? You have to draw the line in this line. Accordingly, you have to do it. Now the steam input of machine 1 is increased. So kilowatt 1 that is shared by machine 1 is increased. So it will shift like this. So this is my value of phi 1 dash, and this is my value of kw 1 dash. Kilowatt change is increased. So this will be my kw 2 dash, it is decreased. So now this triangle will be extended like this for machine 2, because kvr shared is same. So this is my phi 2 dash. This is my value of phi 2 dash, because you can see here it is shifted upwards. So phi 2 dash will be greater than phi 2, but whereas this phi 1 dash will be less than phi 1. This is what is happening. So using this also you can make the calculations. I hope this is clear to you. Now one thing you have to remember, the active power sharing will also depend on what is the speed and load characteristics of a prime mover. So I am just summarizing this here. The active power sharing depends on the speed or frequency versus load characteristics of prime mover also. So in order to properly share this, we have to take my load characteristics should be having a Dupuit characteristics. So we want that whatever is a prime mover, I want my prime mover should have drooping characteristics to share the load properly. So this is for the case of sharing of active power. And reactive power characteristics will depend on two things. One is the reactive power, that is excitation. So we can tell that the reactive power sharing, this depends on two parameters. One is VI characteristics of your generator, and the second one is excitation. We have only seen the excitation, we have not considered VI characteristics. Practically we have to consider VI characteristics also. Similar way, you have to consider the prime mover characteristics for the case of change in load. Let us assume I want to share the load, the two alternators want to share the load, and we have to consider the characteristics of your machine also. So now how to fix it? You have to fix your total KVA or kilowatt of your total machine. So kilowatt will be equal to P1 plus P2. Let us assume this is the characteristic. So this indicates the speed or frequency axis. Let us assume this is the characteristic of my first machine. Draw from this side. This is the characteristic of my second machine. Getting it? So this is my total power. This is equal to P1 plus P2. So how much power will be shared by these respective things will be depending on this. So this indicates what is the power shared by the first machine. This indicates the power shared by the second machine, and when you are extending this, this will intersect at a point. This indicates what is my frequency of my set. Getting it? So let us assume due to some reason the mechanical input to the first machine is increased. When the mechanical input to first machine is increased, the characteristics will shift upwards like this. So this characteristics will shift upward like this. When the characteristics are shifted, you can see the intersecting point is changed now. So this will be your new intersecting point. So this gives what is your value of P1 dash and what is your value of P2. So the load shared by the first machine is increased, but now the disadvantage is the frequency is changed now. This will become F dash. The frequency is increased. So when the set frequency is increased, because if you want to maintain your load frequency constant, the only option available is again decrease the set frequency. How to decrease the set frequency? Decrease the mechanical input to the second machine. So when you decrease the mechanical input to the second machine, the characteristics will shift downwards. So it will go on passing like this. It will intersect with this at this point. So you have to decrease in such a way that both will intersect at the frequency F. Getting it? You have to decrease it accordingly. Now when this is decreased, this will be my final value of the load shared. This will be equal to P2 double dash, and this will be equal to P1 double dash. So in the numerical, whenever you want to solve some numerical, when the load is given, frequency is given, you want to change the load shared by the respective, you can follow this type of procedure, because using this the calculation will be easy. Always this x-axis will be equal to P1 plus P2 is fixed. Draw the drooping characteristics from two opposite sides. This is for machine 1 and this is for machine number 2. So both will intersect at a point. Wherever they are intersecting, that y-axis gives the set frequency and the x-axis gives what is the load sharing percentage by each of these alternators. In this way you can calculate it easily. I hope the load sharing by the alternators is completely clear to you. If you still have any queries, you can leave your comments in the comment section below. I will answer to your queries from there. Thank you. Thank you very much.